were recruited to come to the George Herbert Walker Bush White House
administration
staff.
Right. I went to be the White House Soviet specialist and got lucky enough to be the White House Soviet specialist at the end of the Cold War.
So you were there when the Berlin Wall went down, and did you go into the president and say, let's jump up and down and take credit
for
this?
I was one of the people, the minute that the Berlin Wall fell, a bunch of us went over to the Oval Office, Mr. President, you have to go to Berlin, you have to go for Kennedy, you have to go for Truman, you have to go for Reagan. And he looked at us and he said, what would I do, dance on the wall? He said, this is a German moment, not an American moment. And I'll never forget that because it was just so much George H.W. Bush, self-effacing, modest, a great sense of humility, and it was the right thing. He was absolutely right.
You saw him recently. You were at the Barbara Bush funeral.
I was.
And did you have a chance to talk to him at that time?
I did. I had a chance to talk to him and tell him how much I love him and loved Mrs. Bush. That's a generation that's going to be missed. They were people who understood kindness and humility and gentility. They made their mistakes, most certainly. But when you think about that family and what George H.W. Bush did as a public servant, it makes you think of a wonderful time for our country.
Bill Clinton came along, and in the 1992 election, he defeated your boss.
Right.
Were you shocked by the outcome?
I was. I'd already gone back to Stanford. I became provost. I was surprised, but he had done what he needed to do, and I don't think there will ever be a full accounting of how much it was the way that he did the diplomacy at the end of the Cold War, with respect for Gorbachev, never humiliating the Soviet Union, not dancing on the wall. One of the last things Gorbachev did before he went out to sign the paper that would collapse the Soviet Union and allow Boris Yeltsin to become president of the Russian Federation, he called George H.W. Bush. And he said, we did good things, didn't we? History will judge us well. And I said to President Bush, do you realize how extraordinary this is? Well, he was George H.W. Bush. He said, well, I never thought about it. I said that the president of the Soviet Union, in his last act before the collapse of the Soviet Union, called the American president essentially to seek his affirmation. That was a very big deal. But that's the way he was.